Dear brothers, I left you recently in order to escape from the hustle and bustle of our civilization and settle somewhere on the fringes of the universe, striving for informational harmony. Imagine my surprise when I came across a peculiarity along the way. As it turned out, after searching our archives, it had already been mentioned by my fellow travelers. I found testimonies of Krishna, Yahweh and Buddha. I decided to visit this world and send you an update with a request to add to our archives. After all, information is our greatest good. Certainly worthy of closer scrutiny is the issue of the apocalypse, which was commanded to this oddity by one of the aforementioned visitators, probably Yahweh. In my opinion, hastily. But let our committee decide that. I would not cancel this little world yet. I believe that it is a waste of energy to launch apocalypse at such a low stage of development. If indeed this construct is as flawed as Yahweh judges, it will end by itself. Especially since Krishna and Buddha were not so critical. And then there is the disclaimer that my report and superficial interpretations may be encumbered by experiences from my previous visits to extremely diverse worlds. In this world we find billions of macro creatures populated and controlled by octillions of microorganisms. Interestingly, macro creatures are aware of the existence of microorganisms, but not of their power. Microorganisms, on the other hand, quite opposite, they are aware of their power over some creatures, but not of who their hosts really are. This is an interesting paradox. Population that have developed sophisticated philosophical concepts is under the power of primitive micro beings lacking any philosophy. I don't think this was ever brought up by any of the visitators mentioned, so this claim needs verification. The state of permanent pandemics, cleverly, one has to admit, managed by microorganisms would indicate the correctness of the statement that they rule over macro creatures and not the other way round, which, after all, did not prevent the subordinate beings from producing a rather rich culture, although heavily contaminated with various religious aberrations. But that was to be expected from the fact that they have not understood that they are not the rulers of this world at all. It seems rather strange to me that they worship their heads in various ways, as if the heads carried special value in their culture. Yes, the physiognomies of individuals are important for the reproduction of the species, and some faces also have certain aesthetic or even commercial values. However, the role of the head, or even the organ it contains, does not justify such glorification. On the other hand, the activity of connecting heads, promoted by all their media, is apparently controlled by the micro beings that can spread, thanks to such activities. Or those flat boards with chaotic, colorful spots that they place on the walls and then stare at them. Yes, I notice quite intriguing activities in the minds of some individuals in such situations, but most of them focus on the geometric exercise of matching the rectangle they carry with the shape on the wall. Macro creatures reproduce themselves much less efficiently than micro creatures. However, the way they reproduce is quite bizarre, and they have made a taboo out of it. In fact, the most developed populations seem to neglect their birth at all and ignore the end of their existence. Or the issue of teleportation. They have very advanced mathematics, they have obtained nuclear energy and discovered quantum physics, but they still move in highly archaic methods. Although I also have own theory that they, for reasons we don't understand, have simply given up teleportation just like some gave up eating meat or using polluting substances. I came across a statue of teleportation on a riverbank in one of the cities, which stirs great interest and probably recalls some traumatic events. Of course, local teleportation has its negative sides, but not as much as their, so-called, means of locomotion. The buildings of the most important offices definitely stand out from other buildings. They attract crowds of citizens who are happy to deal with official matters with their families or in organized groups. Brothers indeed, I have never seen such a monumental bureaucracy before. However, I have not been able to decipher what kind of matters they actually deal with there. Their religion, on the other hand, is quite easy to recognize. They admire and joyfully worship beautiful, multiplied objects coming from supernatural, mystical worlds. They visit idyllic temples and often leave them with the cherished object of worship, which they take to their resting places for further adoration. And here I have a certain sacral embarrassment. Although their polytheism is very common, it is so dynamic that I find it hard to comprehend how it could lead them beyond the plush matter. Some kind of weirdness must reign there. In any case, I was leaving this world with a thorn of a riddle. I, who had sucked information from many a black hole. So I send you, dear brothers, this message that will enrich our archives and encourage others. Howdy, or I got a jet into hyperspace. Ahoy!